Hi everyone, in this video I would like to explain about synthesis of ketamine. It is comes under the category of general anesthetics. Specifically it is a type of dissociative anesthetic agent. So the mechanism of action of ketamine is it is a non-competitive antagonist at NMDA receptor. So majorly it can inhibit the influx of calcium ions, it can inhibit the influx of calcium ions, and finally it prevents the depolarization and prevents the excitation of cells. And this is the structure of ketamine. So its parent nucleus is nothing but this is the parent nucleus. We know this name of this molecule, right? It is a cyclohexanone. So cyclohexanone is the parent nucleus. For this cyclohexanone, from the ketone start give the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. At the second position, it consisting of at ortho position chloro phenol, so we can name it as second position. It consisting of chlorophenol as well as methyl amino group. So what is the chemical name of this molecule is 2-ortho-chloro, at the ortho position chlorine and phenyl ring, 2-ortho-chloro-phenol, 2-methyl amino. This is a methyl amino cyclohexanone. This is the IUPAC name for ketamine. And coming to the synthesis of ketamine, while synthesizing ketamine, first starting material we can take a benzene. So chlorobenzene, here take a nitrocarbon atom here. So carbon with nitrogen. So one of the starting material for synthesizing and ketamine is benzene. This is the one starting material. So what is the name of this molecule? This is first position, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. We can name this one as 2-chlorobenzonitrile. This is the one starting material. So next starting material, take instead of cyclohexanone, take the second starting material is, this is a cyclopentane with magnesium bromide. So we can name it as cyclopentyl magnesium bromide. These two are the starting materials. One is 2-chlorobenzonitrile, and the other one is cyclopentyl magnesium bromide. Both are the starting materials. So to react both the molecules, first we have to convert the cyanide into a carboxylic group simply by the process of hydrolysis and add a water. In presence of water, the cyanide group is converted into an acid with the release of ammonia. The acid reacts with magnesium bromide and finally it forms, club both the molecules, benzene, chlorine is same, and here C double bond O, remove this amine group, ammonia, and C double bond O is there here, OH is lost with a magnesium bromide, and finally this ketone is attached with a cyclopentane ring. This is the next one. And next what happens is, here always possess a one hydrogen atom. That hydrogen we have to convert this cyclopentane ring into cyclohexanone. How we are converting is, add one more carbon atom or club this pentane ring with this carbon atom. So how to make the changes in this structure is, simply treat with a bromine Br2. It consisting of Br plus and Br minus. And here H plus and Br lost as an HBr. And finally the Br plus we attached here with the formation of C double bond O, here Br. And the next step is, again go for attachment of here we don't need to require a ketone, we require a methyl amine. So we treat with CH3NH2, and while treating with CH3NH2, it forms a loss of H2O, H2 and O lost as an H2O, and attach this nitrogen to this double bonded carbon, and finally it forms benzene chlorine C double bond NCH3 with cyclopentane, here Br. And next step is hydrolysis. And go for a hydrolysis here. The Br is converted into an OH, and finally it forms HCl in the presence of water. Again, there is a loss of an HBr, and finally it forms C double bond and CH3 cyclopentane here OH. So then finally we have to convert here. Observe this structure. Here it consisting of 5 carbon atoms. This one is the 6th carbon atom. And here there is a breakdown of the bond over here. And finally this carbon atom is clubbed with this carbon atom. Okay, this is the numbering. Just give the numbering for this one. This 5th carbon atom clubbed with this carbon atom. Just it undergoes a cyclization. And finally it forms a molecule with an hydride shift. By hydride shift, and finally it forms club both the molecules, benzene with chlorine is same, and here this carbon atom clubbed with this 5th carbon atom, and finally it forms a cyclopentane. And for this carbon atom, because of the shift of this bond towards this position and attach this H plus to this nitrogen, and it forms an NH CH3, and because of the loss of H plus, it is back converted into an O. And this is the structure of an ketamine. This is cyclohexanone. And coming to the numbering for this molecule, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are already studied the name of this molecule. At the second position, it consisting of an orthochlorophenyl as well as a methyl amino. This is nothing but the structure of an ketamine. So just I want to give the glance of the synthesis. So here the starting material is 2-chlorobenzonitrile. It reacts with cyclopentyl magnesium bromide. So first we have to make an hydrolysis of this cyanide group. Cyanide, remember, cyanide upon hydrolysis always converted into acid with the loss of ammonia. The acid, it reacts with magnesium bromide, and finally there is a loss of a magnesium bromide hydroxide with the loss of this molecule. This C double bond was clubbed with this carbon atom and gives a keto derivative. And here always possess one more hydrogen at the respective corners consisting of CH2. And in order to form a reaction here, there is a loss of H plus by adding a Br2. There is a loss of HBr with the formation of bromide derivative. And this ketone is converted into an respective imine derivative simply by treated with a methyl amine. In the presence of methyl amine, there is a loss of ion water, and finally it forms an one intermediate. And this molecule, upon addition of water, the Br is lost as again as HBr, and by attaching an hydroxy group. And finally it undergoes an important change, that is nothing but hydride shift. How the hydride shift will occur? By the breakdown of the bond between first carbon and fifth carbon, there is a cleavage of bond. The bond is shift towards this position. This carbon gets negative charge. By the shifting of this bond towards this position, get negative, this carbon gets positive. Attach this carbonyl carbon with the fifth negative charged carbon, and finally it is already 5-membered. By attaching this carbon, it is converted into 6-membered ring. That is nothing but cyclohexanone. Whatever the H plus, it is shift from the OH to a nitrogen atom with the formation of a ketamine. This is very, very important topic for your final examination. This is about the synthesis of ketamine. Thank you.